Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss important questions from the topic derivatives. So this topic is from securities market for your SEBI grade examination. So friends, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. So let's begin. So first of all, log in to our website anujindal.in. Then just click on this link. Then we'll go to the quizzes section, and here, as you can see, quizzes are available for different examinations like RBI, SEBI, UGC, NABARD. So we will go to SEBI grade A, and now here you can see there are quizzes on different topics. So here I am going to click on this link, securities market derivatives, right? So start quiz. So this is the first question. What is the difference between spot price and futures price of an asset called? So in a derivative, there is an underlying asset, because derivative is just a contract. So the price of the derivative, it depends upon the underlying asset, and this underlying asset, it can be any asset, real asset or financial asset. So it can be stock, bonds, commodities, currency, etc. So there are two prices, spot price and future price. So spot price is the market price of the underlying asset, and futures price is the price of the derivative contract. So derivative contract, which are traded on exchange, so they have a price, futures price. So this price changes daily, like the spot price changes daily. Similarly, futures price also changes daily, right? So they are asking you the difference between spot price and futures price. So the difference is called basis. Basis, or we also call it cost of carry. So here the correct option is option B. And there are some other terms also. So here there is a term called margin. So what is margin? So margin is the money which is required to be deposited upfront at the time of entering into a derivative contract. So margin basically acts as a security. Then spread, what is spread? So spread is the difference between two futures price. Then there is swap. So swap is a derivative contract. And contango. So contango means when the futures price is more than spot price, then it is called contango. So here the correct option is option B, basis. Now next question, question 2. Consider the below statements regarding derivatives. So you are given three statements. Let us read the statements one by one. Statement 1, in India, all option contracts have to be American in nature. Now statement 1 is incorrect. Let me tell you why. So options, they can be classified into American options or European options. So what is the difference between the two? So in American option, option can be exercised either on the expiration date or even before the expiration date. But in European option, option can be exercised only on the expiration date, right? So in India, all option contracts, they are of European type. So in India, an American type option cannot be issued, right? So statement 1 is incorrect, because all option contracts, they are of European type. Then statement 2, writer of a call option is bearish and writer of a put option is bullish. So in option contract, there are two parties. One is the buyer of option and one is the seller of option. So buyer of option is also called holder, and seller of option is also called writer. So let me draw a table. So buyer of a put option is bullish in nature, and buyer of a put option is bearish in nature. Whereas seller of a call option is bearish in nature, and seller of a put option is bullish in nature. So the statement 2 says that writer of a call option, writer means seller, writer of a call option is bearish, which is correct, and writer of a put option is bullish, which is also correct. So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, risk profile of futures is symmetric, whereas risk profile of options is asymmetric. So statement 3 is right. So what do we mean by symmetric and asymmetric? So symmetric means similar. So if you divide something into two, and if both the halves are equal, then we say it is symmetric, right? So futures, the risk profile in futures is symmetric, and the risk profile in options is asymmetric. So let me explain this. So in futures, both buyer, So both buyer as well as seller of a futures contract, they are subject to unlimited gains and unlimited losses. But in case of options, buyer can enjoy unlimited gains, but buyer is subject to only limited losses, and the loss is limited to the premium paid, right? So risk profile in case of options is asymmetric, because the risk of buyer and seller is not the same in options, but the risk of buyer and seller is same in futures. So statement 3 is right. So only statement 1 is incorrect. So the question is asking you which of the above statements are correct. So statement 2 and statement 3, they both are correct. So the correct option is option E. Now next question 3. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have also discussed this topic on our Telegram group. So we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions on that group. Also, a lot of relevant information regarding various examinations is being shared. So do join the Telegram group and get the benefits. Now question 3. There are 4 main derivative contracts: forwards, futures, options and swaps. Forwards and futures are very similar, but still there are some differences. So you are given here 3 statements. Let us read. Statement 1. Futures are traded over the counter, whereas forwards are exchange traded. So statement 1, it is incorrect. Why? Because futures, they are traded on an exchange, whereas forwards, they are traded over the counter. This is because forwards, they are customized contracts, and futures, they are standardized contracts. So statement 1 is not correct. Statement 2, forwards are riskier than futures due to presence of counterparty risk. So statement 2 is right. So what is counterparty risk? So in a forward or future, there are 2 parties, buyer and seller. So counterparty risk means that one of the party does not fulfill the contract. So this is the risk. So this risk, it is present in forwards, but it is not present in futures. This is because futures, they are traded on an exchange, and there is a clearing corporation which guarantees the settlement. So counterparty risk is eliminated in case of futures due to presence of clearing corporation. But forwards, they are traded over the counter, so there is no clearing corporation. So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, forwards are standardized contracts, whereas futures are customized contracts. So this statement is wrong, because I've just told you that forwards are customized. So forwards are tailor-made and futures are standardized. So forward contract, they are between 2 parties, and the 2 parties, they can make the contract as per their terms and conditions. So that is why it is customized or custom made. But in futures, they are traded on an exchange and there are standard rules. So there will be a standard quantity, standard price, standard quality. So statement 3 is incorrect. So the question is asking you which of the above statements are incorrect. So statement 1 and statement 3, they are incorrect. So the correct option here is option D. Now next question 4. Which of the following statements is incorrect? So you are given here 5 statements. So you have to see which of them is incorrect. So statement A, short position in a put option means buying a put option. So here you need to understand 2 things. There is a long position and there is a short position, right? So long position basically means when the person has bought a contract, and short position means when the person has sold the contract. So the person who buys the contract is said to be in a long position, and the person who sells the contract is said to be in a short position. So statement A is saying short position in a put option. So there are 2 options, call option and put option. Call option is the option to buy, so it is the right to buy, and put option gives the right to sell. So the question is saying short position in a put option means buying a put option. So statement A is incorrect, because short position means selling a option, whether call option or put option. So short position in a put option means selling a put option. So statement A is incorrect. Statement B, long position in a call option means buying a call option. So this is right, because long position means buying an option. Statement C, a call option is said to be in the money if actual price is more than the strike price. So this concept I need to teach you, the concept of in the money and out of money. So I will explain you with the help of this table. So this is the table. So if the actual price is more than the strike price, so AP is actual price and SP is strike price. So if the actual price is more than the strike price, then the call option is said to be in the money and put option is said to be out of money. But if the actual price is less than the strike price, then call option is said to be out of money and put option is said to be in the money. And if actual price is equal to strike price, then both call and put options, they are said to be at the money, right? So statement C is saying a call option is said to be in the money if the actual price is more than the strike price. So statement C, it is right. Statement D, a put option is said to be out of money if actual price is more than the strike price. So this again is correct. And statement E, in case of European option, option holder can exercise his right only on the expiration date. So this statement is again correct, as I have told you in one of the previous questions. So you can see only statement A, it is incorrect. So the correct option here is option A. Now next question. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that we have posted this quiz on our website, as I have shown you in the beginning of this video. So you can attempt this quiz by going to our website. Also, quizzes on other topics for a SEBI grade examination and for other examinations are being posted on the website. So do attempt those quizzes to see your preparation level. So the link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now final question, question 5. Dash is a standardized forward contract to buy and sell at a predetermined rate at a predetermined future date. So the options are swap, option, future, T-bill and contango. So I am not going to tell you the answer to this question now. So you need to mention the answer to this question in the comment section below. Then afterwards, I will post the correct answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do hit the subscribe button to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.